Today, we are at this insane triple shipping container home in Joshua Tree, California, that comes with its own container pool. We're gonna be doing a full tour and a mini cost breakdown. So stick around towards the end. Let's now go and check this place out. I am shooting inside right now because it is literally the windiest day I have ever done a video shoot on. There are wind gusts of up to 40 miles per hour right now. It's pretty wild out here in the desert. But this is a 3-bed, 2-bath shipping container home that took the owners about 30 months to complete. It's quite the story, so stick around towards the end for more on that, including the overall build cost and some of their key expenses. But I love this layout, especially the master bathroom. I've never seen so many showers in one spot before. And you have so much outdoor space, like your container pool that you saw earlier and the rooftop deck. So I can't wait to go over every square inch of this place with you all. So let's now go and start the full tour. Let's go and check out this triple shipping container home. I think the overall color scheme of this spot matches the desert surroundings perfectly, especially with the orange container pool and the orange doors that you see throughout. But let's now get a little bit closer to see by far one of my favorite features. That feature, of course, is the pool, and man, just look at that view, but more on that soon. As I'm now going to walk down some stairs that lead deeper into the pool. I also loved that glass pane that is right in the center. You can see straight into the water from afar. The water is super bright and blue. And now off to the side, there are these two nice reclining chairs, a small table, and some string lights. And if we look when the sun is more down, a part of the reason why the water is so bright is that there are some lights inside of the pool. And last but not least, off to the side, just look at the size of this chair. It is massive. Continuing with the outdoor space, you have the first of two outdoor dining table sets on the left, and this is the main seating area. You have a gas-powered fireplace, but let's now shift to the top of the middle container there because you have a nice rooftop deck. There is an additional outdoor dining table set and an outdoor sofa there on the far right. And I'm now briefly going to point out there on the top right, this is a solar-powered property. But let's now go and see more of the view as promised. This is what you can see from the rooftop deck. I'm now going to venture out a little bit to the desert. This is a close-up of what the famous Joshua Tree looks like. It's obviously for what this area is named after. There are thousands of them all over the place. And this is me flying my drone out there with all the mountains in the background. And now this is unrelated. This is not the home. It is called Desert X. It's actually an art installation that's pretty close nearby to this Airbnb. I just wanted to point it out. Again, it's called Desert X. If you love containers, it's worth a visit. But that's it for everything outside. I'm now going to open up the very windy door and let's now go and switch and go and see the interior. When you first enter, you'll be staring down the middle container, which contains the living room, kitchen, and dining area. We're gonna start first with just the living room area for now because we have a lot of space to cover. So looking back in this direction towards the door, you have some very brightly colored chairs and pillows on this one wall. There's also a few art pieces directly above that. Then in the far corner, you can find this comfortable leather couch and a smart TV opposite of that. But let's now go through this other door, which is next to the front door on the left. This leads into another container and the master bedroom. There are 3 bedrooms in total in this home. The desert theme continues with those art pieces hanging on the wall, and there is a smart TV there in the corner. Also, as soon as you enter to the left, there is a spacious walk-in closet area. But one of my favorite rooms in the interior is actually the master bathroom. There are actually two sinks in this room. You have a pretty standard mirror over both of them, but the best part is the bathing area. You have that massive soaking tub there and actually two separate shower heads. So you've got that right, one bathtub, two shower heads. It's pretty wild. Let's head back to the middle container now and go in a little further. And this will take us to the kitchen. There is plenty of countertop space throughout, and you can see some of your key kitchen appliances like your dishwasher and sink and your stovetop and oven. There are also two shelves. They have all of your glasses and mugs, plates and bowls. And if we go down even a little bit further, all the way to the end of the counter, you can then find your large fridge and freezer unit. Now, if we look along this other wall, there are a few extra coffee mugs and a nicely decorated sign at the top, not to mention a few more appliances like your microwave and Keurig. I'll briefly mention this, but you can open up this big garage door for easy access to the outdoor space. Next, there is your indoor dining table. There are four black chairs that are around it. And if we go all the way towards the end of this middle container, you can find that big mirror in the middle. But for now, we're gonna go through this door on the far left-hand side. This will take us into bedroom number 2 of 3. It's quite similar to the master bedroom, just a bit smaller. The desert decorations continue though, and this is a queen mattress. Back in the hallway, this middle door leads to the second bathroom. This one has just one shower in it, but the room is laid out very well for the space that it has. You can find some tiling in your toilet and another desert painting along this wall. But in the hallway again, on the right hand side, there is a lovely washer and dryer unit. If we go through this last door on the far right, this takes us into the third and final bedroom. This one has another queen mattress in it and a smart TV at the end. But let's now go and do the cost breakdown. Okay, it is time for a little cost breakdown and some more information. I got all my notes right here. Let's dive in. I'm gonna start off first with some key expenses. I'm just gonna rifle on through. Please keep in mind, we are in Southern California. It's very expensive out here. And the owner started this build in 2020. So a lot of things, especially cost, have gone up now that it is 2023. So the owner first acquired this piece of land back in 2020 for a total cost of $36,000. He told me that now, if you were to purchase it in 2023, it'd probably be valued closer to $150,000. So it's about 4 or 5x its value, just the land alone. Next, we have the unique container pool. Definitely one of the key pieces of this place. I keep talking about it. That came in at about $50,000. Next, for all of the furnishings, that includes both indoor and outdoor furniture. So everything on the rooftop deck, in the bedrooms, the chair I'm sitting on right now, that all came out to about $20,000. Next, one of the pricier single item things is the foundation. The foundation came out to about $72,000. Then we have the flooring. The flooring came out to about $14,000. And last but not least, the solar panels came out to about $40,000, which the owner financed. And now the moment you've all been waiting for, the total all-in cost for this project, including everything, land, septic, well, permitting, everything, comes out to $690,000. Now this home is about 960 square feet total. So that is $718 per square foot for everything. Or if we're talking about just the home, excluding expenses like land, that comes out closer to $350 per square foot. In terms of funding for the $690K, the owner told me they put in about $250K in cash, $400K came from refinancing and loans, and another $40K was financed for the solar. Three final notes from the owner. He told me he expects the $690K container home to appraise for about $1.2 million. The permitting in this county was also extremely difficult. He does not expect to build in this area again, and it added another 12 to 14 months to his timeline just to finalize all of the permitting. He also did not use a general contractor. He still did a lot of the labor himself. If he had hired out a GC, it would have cost him closer to $1 million overall. So it definitely saves to do at least some of your own labor. Now, I'll begin to close out this video, but before I do, before you all go to start and spam the comments with how ridiculously priced this container home is, please keep in mind, guys, we are in Southern California. This is one of the most expensive places in the world to build something. And especially when you have a container home that comes with a lot of extra permitting and extra costs. And I tell you, every container home owner will back me up on this. A container home is not cheaper than a traditional build. They are about the same, if not more expensive than a traditional build. I guarantee you, every container home owner is nodding their heads right now. So I hope you guys found this information to be helpful. Please comment down below if you did so I can do more cost breakdowns like this. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.